right, here it is, guys. Finally, it is here, the RG Zeong. Never really thought I'd be excited about a Zeong kit, to be honest. And when I heard this was coming out as a real grade, I thought, don't really like the Zeong all that much. But the more I've seen of this kit, of course, the better it looks. So Bandai did an amazing job of taking a design that's kind of not very cool and making it look really, really cool with this RG kit. So I think they really knocked it out of the park, but of course I have to build it up to find out for myself. But as you can see, it's in a pretty big box, and this is the standard version of the kit. There's another version of this kit that's coming out for a first run only, that is the effect parts set version that comes with a bunch of effect parts for it, and you also get some effect parts to go with this to make with the RX-782 real grade kit as well too, to make the kind of final shooting battle pose that you can make to recreate the scene from the anime. I didn't opt for that version with all the effect parts and everything. I just opted for just the standard version, but I mean, as you can see, it's already a pretty large box for just this one. So a lot of parts in there. The Zeong is a pretty big mobile suit. It's not going to be the biggest RG. I think it's still not quite as big as the Sazabi, for example, but it should be pretty large. Let's go ahead and check out the box. So our box right here on the front is just in typical RG style. We got the close-up there in the background and then the full body shot over here on this side and all the text down there at the bottom. Once again, got some cool little bit of weathering there on the close-up. You can see that it does look really nice there on the image in the background. Of course, just very spooky looking face of the Zeong there with this big wide open mouth laser kind of thing. Very strange design anyway. Over here on the side, you can see this number 34 in the real graded line. And down here on the bottom of the box, you got some more details about the advanced MS joint. Basically just going to be for the hands, I think, with this kit. So they're getting away with the more recent RG kits, less and less advanced MS joint they're using in there. They're basically just like small master grades at this point. And there you can see all the inner frame detail looking very nice. Authentic looks and mobile structure there. So you got all this heart-shaped bottom side of the kit there, minus the legs, of course, and then how that looks kind of all spread out. It looks really cool, all these joint parts and everything, the separation of the armor and the skirt part, it looks amazing. Some details over here about some of the articulation gimmicks of the elbow there. You can also have the hands shooting off on the wires, and you can see you can move the mono eye around in the head there too. You can open the cockpit, all that looks really cool. Here's how the kit is going to look just straight out of the box with the stickers applied, and that's it. It looks fantastic just straight out of the box there. That's kind of another key feature of the RG kits, is how good they're meant to look just straight out of the box. And then on the top of the box here, you got some action poses. So there it is with the hand shooting out there on the wire with the laser fingers and everything. There's with both of them deployed like that. As far as I know, I don't think that this comes with a base, although I really think that it should, but I don't believe that it does. We'll see here in a minute once we get it open. I don't remember at the moment. So you can see the base plugs onto the back of the skirt there, which is pretty cool. So that should make posing it pretty interesting. And with the list price of around 5,500 yen, it is going to be one of the more expensive real grades, but obviously, as you can see here, we got a lot of plastic in the box, so that doesn't seem too out of character for something like this. And it looks like we do have base included, so that's nice. That's good. I wasn't sure about that. Just want to go ahead and take a look at the manual here first before we get a look at all the runners and everything. There are quite a few of those, as you can see. On the front, just typical style RG manual there, just the close-up image we saw on the box. On the back side, we got the decal layout where all the decals are going to be placed around on the kit, and at the bottom there you've also got the color guide there in Japanese and in English. On the inside front pages here, you've got the parts list. You've got a lot of parts here obviously with that and the bases and everything. So we got some information up here, a unit dedicated to new types at the end of the 1 year war bearing the name of Zeon. So there you got some information there in Japanese and in English, just kind of background about the Zeong, I guess. And then we start actually on the head. Normally real grade kits start from the feet up. That's kind of the normal kind of build order of these, but obviously because it doesn't have any feet, I guess we're doing it the opposite, from the head and then chest and then out from there. So a little ways into the manual, as usual, we've got another section here of information about the weapons. In this case, as usual, it's also just all in Japanese, no English for this, but basically just the weapons being the hands and the laser cannons and stuff are going to be kind of its main weapons. Doesn't have any handheld weapons or anything like that, like we would normally expect. And then once we get a little bit further on here, we got some more information, again, all in Japanese, about the thrusters, the head unit there. So you got some about that. I guess the head unit obviously can come off and you can have that flying around as well too. Then just finishing off there with the construction of the base and just how to kind of mount and pose everything, how to move the mono eye around, how to remove the landing gear. It does have some landing gear. If you don't want to put it on an action base, you can have it just sat on the ground there just using these included kind of a landing gear parts there for that, so you can do that if you prefer. Alright, so here's our typical RG style sticker sheet here, and you can see you got some of those foil ones down at the bottom, some bronze ones there as well too. Overall, it's not really as big as I would have expected. I've seen other Rio Grey kits where the kit is like generally smaller, but the sticker sheet is much larger. This one is a pretty small sticker sheet considering the size of the mobile suit. And we got three wires included here, two black ones there for the hands, and this red one which we're going to use for adding some detail into the kind of skirting bits there. And you've got all your base parts here in gray. So you've got three base plates and this runner here, BAACB5 for all the arm parts of the base there. This is basically just an action base of action base 5, right? The 100 scale version of that, basically, so you get that included in gray. And you also have two of these, BA14, these small little bases which you're going to use basically for the arms. These are also in gray. Our A runner here is in four colors. You have a couple of clear parts down there at the bottom, basically for the dome piece and the mono eye. You got a couple of purple parts up there at the top. Those look really nice, and some black over here on the side, and some kind of dull navy blue color over there. And then we're going to be, as typical with a Rio Grey kit, is our advanced MS joint. This is advanced MS joint number 18 for this. As you can see, it's basically just the hand parts for the Xiang. So those blue, kind of like a dull, light bluish gray color parts for the hands are molded together in here with the gray parts for like the inner frame of the hands, the fingers, I guess I should say, in there as well too. We got a bunch more of that light bluish gray color here for the main kind of armor color here on the C runner. And as you can see, a lot of really nice detail in on those parts. That's continued on here as well too to runner D1, some more armor parts there, and then also runner D2. Gonna be some different parts here, some bigger parts there for the skirt parts and things like that. Runner E in this dark gray color is getting into the frame parts, and you can see a lot of really nice detail on these parts there. So those are gonna look really cool once you get this frame all built up. And that's continued on here onto runner F as well too. A lot of really great detail on that frame. Man, it's gonna look really nice. I think this is gonna look so cool. Don't worry, still plenty more frame parts to go here on runner G. We've got two of this G runner. And even more yet still here on runner H as well too. You can see it's basically a bunch of thruster parts, it looks like, for underneath the skirt. Got two of this H runner. And then runner I is kind of our alternate color for the frame parts and detail parts, basically, aside from the armor, is in this really interesting dark blue color. And we do also have runner I2 as well, which is a copy of this section of the runner here. Now for runner J here, it's in this really bright red color, and we've got two of this J runner there for some red detail bits. And the color of the plastic really reminds me a lot of the RE100 Vignagina color, which a lot of people did not like, myself included. It didn't really look good on that kit, just how bright that red color was, and it was kind of weird. That said, on this kit, with it being just a few little parts here and there, I think it's going to be much more easy on the eyes where it's not the entire kit. Runner K here is in this very nice kind of light lavender color. Runner L, some parts here in a nice slightly orangish yellow color, and then runner L2 in a slightly lighter color of yellow for some yellow parts there around the arm, so you'll have two-tone yellow, which is nice. So that is everything, guys. Let me go ahead and get this all built up and we'll see how it looks. Alright guys, here it is all put together, and man, I gotta say Bandai really nailed it with this kit, for sure. I keep telling you guys, there was a time when I just kind of lost interest in Rio Grey kits a little bit, but definitely the more recent Rio Grey kits, the past couple years, they've just really been killing it with this line, making some really super amazing kits. And for them to be able to take a design that I normally am not really that into and just make me really love this kit, man, that is saying something. And so, I mean, Ben has done that a number of times with me with different designs where I didn't really like the design of the mobile suit until I built the kit. So it does happen from time to time, but man, it always amazes me. As you guys can see here, the kit looks amazing. You got the multiple tones of color on there, as always with Rio Grey kits, that just look really fantastic. The multiple tones of dark blue and light blue, the multiple tones of yellow, all the details on there. I did put some stickers on, not all, of course. There's a lot more stickers you can put on if you prefer, but I just put a couple on there just so you guys get the idea of how the sticker is going to look on the plastic. But man, it's pretty amazing. So let's go ahead and take a look. For the accessories, obviously going to be pretty minimal, as it doesn't really use any weapons or shield or anything like that. I mean, things that would hold in the hand. So you have the base, which is very nice. Like I said, I do like it in that gray color. You have all the extra parts for that, like changing the height of the base and all the different connectors and things that aren't really going to be used for this particular kit. But if you do want to use this base for anything else, you have all those parts included. You got the two smaller arms here for holding up the arms of the Xiang when they go shooting out. So you've got some custom adapter parts in there for plugging into the arms. And these are meant to just plug down into the base, but you do also have these pieces you could plug into if you wanted to have this just flying out on its own separately, disconnected from the main base. just on their own. You've got your two wires for the arms, and I'll show you how those work here in just a second. But lastly, you just have some landing gear parts here, which look really nice on one side. On the opposite side, unfortunately, though, they have a bunch of hollow gaps, so that's a little bit disappointing. Let me show you how those work here on the bottom. This is your action base adapter, which will just plug onto that part right there, and you can plug that onto the action base. Alternatively, around here on the back, you can lift up this little panel here off the back. And there's another spot where you can attach this onto an action base right there on the back side of the back skirt. As for the landing gear, basically these 1, 2, 3 parts here, you'll remove and then place the landing gear there in their place. So once those are plugged on there, gonna look like that. And then you can just set it down like that. You don't have to actually have it on an action base or anything. So it is kind of nice, I suppose, to be able to do that, basically, but ultimately I think most people are probably good just going to keep up on an action base. Let's go ahead and take a closer look at the kit and all the articulation and everything, starting off with the head. So the head is kind of similar to the Mastergrade 2.0 Zaku 2, where you turn the head and the Model Y turns at the same time. So you can see when you turn, that will turn along with that. So that's really cool how you can do that, and that's just kind of automated. There's a little gear in there that does that. The head will move up to there, and you can see this whole kind of color section will move up, so that moves up really high like that for some cool flying poses. And then down all the way to there, you can see there's a couple points of articulation all within there. There's like a joint up in the head and then at the base of the neck, and then this whole section moves like that, so plenty of articulation there to get that head moving around. Now you can make the Model Y look up, but you have to remove this part on the top of the head, and you're just supposed to take off this little part on the top of there, and then you could move the Model Y to look up like that, and then just put the dome back on top of there like that. If you wanted to have that looking up, you'll just be omitting this part on the inside of the head like that. That does give you some nice detail, but you know, you can't really see it all that well inside of there if you wanted to have it posing like that. Another thing you'll notice is that that is a clear piece for the Mono Y. I've just gone ahead and stuck the sticker on there just for the time being, because with it just being a clear piece behind another clear piece, it kind of makes it hard to see. So just so that you guys can see the Mono Y a little bit better, I've gone ahead and just stuck that sticker on. This little hatch here on the back of the head does also open up. You can open that out like that, and so that's pretty easy enough. And also the head, of course, does come off pretty easily. Now, unfortunately, this is not a 3mm hole where you should be able to just plug this onto like your standard action base like this to have it in a flying away pose like that. It doesn't actually fit on there. It's a much larger bit. So that's kind of weird. But also while we're here, these little bits on the side of the head do also move forward and back as well too. These little thruster guys there like that. But overall, I mean, the head does look really great. It's such a weird, goofy design. I don't like it by any means, but I mean, it looks about as good as it's gonna look with those really bright red colored parts, really sharp detail on there, and the little bits of detail everywhere. Typical RG style, it looks fantastic. So speaking of open hatches, this one here on the chest does also open up, but it's a little bit trickier because you can't just pull it out. You have to like pull it out and then down at the same time. So a little bit easier to do if you're using a tool or something probably. There we go, like that. Yeah, like I said, easier said than done. But that pops out of there and that opens up. Not really much of a cockpit or anything in there. There's a little bit of detail, but not really too much. So that just pops open like so. Now these bits here on the front and back of the torso, these thruster bits are really cool in that when you move them, the little thruster bell, the vernier up inside there, pokes out a little bit as you angle this out. So when you pull that out like that, those open up and that vernier pops down a little bit, which is very cool. So it's gonna be really minimal, kind of hard to see. But you can see it's kind of tucked up inside there, but when you angle this out like that, it pops out like so. So that's pretty awesome. And the same thing goes for the backside as well too. You can pop these out and that looks really nice. As for the articulation here in the torso section though, you can't really rotate it necessarily or bend it side to side, but the front and back bend is really quite nice because you have 2 points of articulation, one between the chest and the stomach and one between the stomach and the waist section. So you've got a bend there and also a lower bend down there. So you can get a really far backwards bend there out of that, and forwards all the way like that. So it's really quite nice for doing some extreme poses with this massive skirt section and the top section like that, forward and back. As we saw, the head can go pretty far forward, so if you bend the head all the way up and this all the way up like that, the head and the skirt section are almost like parallel. It's pretty crazy like that, so the articulation is pretty insane for that section. Ooh, let me just cut in here later actually and add this in, that actually about this articulation, that there's not much rotation here as it is in the middle section, but if you do extend it up like that, then you'll be able to rotate it. So if you just extend that, and then you can rotate that to the side all like that, something like that. Anyway, so there is a little bit of rotation. Just wanted to clarify that for you guys. Moving on to the shoulders, the whole shoulder section itself will move up and down, and then this end part will also move up and down a little bit on its own there, so you have some really nice articulation with that. The whole shoulder section will swing out to the front, and you can actually extend this out a little bit more to swing that even farther to the front like that. That whole mechanism in there is pretty nice, and then that will also go back a bit like that as well too. So you got some nice range movement for that. This little armor panel up on here will also move up and down on the top of the kind of upper arm inside there. That moves, and this whole arm of course will move up. If you extend out the shoulder joint, basically you can get the arm up to about there. That's going to be the extent of the upward movement of that before the shoulder armor is just kind of getting in the way there. Otherwise, we just got some rotation here at the top of the arm, and this upper arm is just really great because you have a bunch of different pieces going together here to get a lot of nice color separation between the gray and that dark or blue color there. As for the elbow joint, you've got a double joint there that will give you a pretty full bend just because of this big massive yellow section there. That's going to be about the extent of how far you can bend that, but that's pretty nice. The arm will just come disattached from there, and that's where you'll stick your wire in that side and in that side. And then to put this on the base, this part separates a little bit like that, and then this is where you can plug the base adapter into that for having this flying on there like so. And then the hand is just on a ball joint, but then you also have a hinge at the base of the wrist there as well too. And then of course you've got joints between all your knuckles in the fingers as well here too, so you can move those around everywhere. Of course this is on the insert molded frame part, so just be a little bit careful with that, don't play around with it too much. And so it looks pretty cool when you got these on a wire. We'll take a look at that here in a moment, but just want to share with you guys, if you are like me and you didn't opt for the full beam effect parts set version of this, and I just honestly just didn't really care for it, so that's why I didn't, but if you did want to put any effect parts in this, any 1/144 scale beam saber effect parts should fit into here. So if you want to have like just one pointing finger like that, you could do that. These fit into there fine, or the shorter type, the longer type or shorter type, doesn't matter. 1/144 scale beam saber effect parts should all fit into there, into the fingertips like that pretty easily. So for example, doing something like that is totally possible, which is pretty fun. Now onto the skirt section, which is honestly the main course of this kit. It's pretty amazing. So you got tons of just really nice detail on here. The separation of the different colors going on there, all the little bits of gray frame poking through the armor here. On the underside, it looks even better. All those red thruster bells in there. And that red wire we saw in the unboxing, that's up in here. It's a little bit hard to see. It's right up in there, that little bit of red that you can see up inside there. So it's not gonna be very visible at all, but it definitely does add a nice little bit of red. Now, one thing too, on the note of whether we're going to get a perfect Xiong in the future, as you can see where this section plugs into there could very easily be replaced with a set of legs to be plugged into there instead. So I think it is very possible that we might get a perfect Xiong in the future. You also notice that that hip connector piece can slide down, but how you need to do that is to move this part up, pull this gray part back like that. That will turn that section, and then you put this kind of blue part back in there to lock that in place. And that will make these massive thruster sections more protruded downward to be more kind of sticking out. And then you can, that frees them up for more articulation as you can point them out to the side more once they're pushed up into there. You can't really move them out to the side very much, but once they're pulled down, you can move them out to the side. You can also rotate these a little bit forward and back, so you can rotate that forward a little bit. And obviously, as you can see here, these sections of skirt all break apart. You can put them all together so it makes a nice flat round surface all the way around, but you can break this up into sections and kind of strategically pull that out and then pull it out away from the skirt a little bit, and then it's just on a ball joint. You can kind of move that around and out of the way, and the same thing goes for basically all the section of the skirt armor here. Just pop it out and then it's free to move around. This section as well too, just pop this out and then that's free to move around. This back section here as well will just move up and down like that, so you can move that up and all up inside of there. You've got tons of really nice mechanical detail with those mechanical frame parts on the underside of the armor. All these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 little thrusters in there. I shouldn't say little, they're not that little. These can all also be articulated. You can rotate them a little bit and then change the angle of them a little bit there as well. They don't move quite as much as the main ones, but you can see you can move those around. You just got loads of nice detail up inside of there. So with all the skirt sections protruded outward, it's a pretty impressive look here for the Xiong. Just everything opened up like that and all that detail. It's pretty crazy, and those all angled out like that. It's a very impressive look for that. I don't really know how else I can describe it, just that it looks awesome, all that detail in there. I mean, just even unpainted, it looks fantastic, but you can just imagine once this is fully painted and you actually paint in all the little details in there, it's gonna look pretty insane. And then just even from the outside as well too, obviously not as much going on here, but still quite a lot of detail on the outside as well. Now, unfortunately, I don't have a real great RX-72 on hand to compare, but there it is with the HG Revive Gundams, just so you can get a sense of how this compares to the 1-44 scale RX-78. And I mean, looks great. It looks really nice compared with the RX-78 too. They're gonna make a really nice set. But I mean, there you have it, guys. With the kind of lack of any other accessories or anything like this, there's not really too much else to talk about the kit, but basically it's amazing if you like RG kits, if you just like any kits. I mean, just if you're watching this video, basically you should check out this kit. It's an amazing kit, really cool. Even if you're not a really big fan of the Zeon, hey, I totally get you. I was there, but I mean, it's a lot of fun. So I mean, if you're interested at all, I would definitely recommend checking this kit out. If you've built other RG kits like the Sazabi and liked it, you should definitely check this kit out as well too, because you know, it's a very similar kind of feeling. It has some cool like armor opening panel gimmicks there with that, really nice detail, a really solid feel as well too. This kit feels completely solid. There's nothing on that that feels loose or finicky at all. It's a super solid kit, really nice construction. It was fun to put together, interesting, obviously, because it's a very different design, so it's a totally unique kind of building experience as well too. So in that sense, it's all kind of very similar to the Sazabi. So I mean, like, if you built that kit and loved it, the RG Sazabi, then definitely check this one as well too. Obviously, it still is a pretty unique design though, so it's not necessarily going to appeal to everyone, I understand, and the lack of accessories might also be unappealing to people who like having a lot of different guns and accessories, things like that, handheld accessories that you might want to use with your kits. Obviously, it's just not that kind of mobile suit, but otherwise, I think there's definitely a lot of appeal with this kit, and like I said before, Bandai just really did an amazing job on this kit, so hats off to Bandai for this one. And I do definitely think that there's a very good chance that they will eventually make a Perfect Zeon variant of this. Probably it's going to be a P-Bandai kit. I don't know if it's going to be like a full set of the full Perfect Zeon, or if it's just going to be an add-on set, basically just build the legs that you can add on to your main kit here. I would imagine probably they're going to make it available as both an add-on set or a full set. But in my opinion, that does seem very likely. Now, would I recommend just waiting for that to happen? I don't know. If you don't mind waiting, then I guess, yeah, wait a little while. Who knows if or when that is ever going to come out. But I mean, if you are really super excited about this kit, then don't wait, just pick it up now. And if they make the Perfect Zeon later, you know, we'll see. But overall, just between all the details and the articulation, all the moving parts and the gimmicks and everything, just a really fantastic kit. So though, if you guys do have any other further questions or comments, of course, do feel free to leave those down below. And in the video description down below, you guys will see the link to USA Gundam Store. Check this kit out and everything else there at USA Gundam Store. And you can save 10% off everything there using my coupon code as well too, ZAKORELIUS10. So use that to save yourself some money as well too. So as always, big thank you to USA Gundam Store for making it all possible. And until next time, guys, hope you're all having a great day. I'll see you later. Bye, everyone.